Your mind, and now I turn to find you looking back at me. Well, I may have changed a bit inside, but more or less I'm as I used to be. You're still the only one that makes me nervous, makes me nauseous when you come around. You seem a bit distracted if you're expecting someone else.
Hey, I thought I roped those stairs off up there.
Well, how are we supposed to get down? Use the fire escape?
No, don't do that. They're a little shaky.
Hey, what are you gonna fix the toilet, man?
What, I look like a miracle worker to you? It's on the list, pal. Believe that fairy?
Mr. Vasco, you want me to come in with you?
Don't need any help, so piss off, skimp herder.
Gonna have to use the side entrance, crusty old.
You guys talking about the gimp? It was a car accident. Drunk driver. I had to let some people into his apartment from the hospital to retrofit it.
A drunk driver? How awful. Yuri, help him. Help the man.
Okay, all right. Hold on, man. You're welcome.
Oops, excuse me. Mr. Vasco, it's been a long time since we've seen you in here. We were so sorry to hear about the accident. You know, it was a terrible thing.
Well, I'm all finished here. Yeah, I'm just gonna let it dry, and then I'll be back to paint it.
Oh! No! Don't! My fault. In fact, if you need anything else, anything at all, I can get it for you. You just say the word, Mr. Vasco.
I'm sorry. It takes a little getting used to, you know, with this.
I'm sure it does. I'm sure. Yeah.
Can you believe this guy?
Do you like pea soup? Because we're having a 2-for-1 special right now, and I would be very, very happy to get the kids.
Pass that blow.
I'm just ow, wait,
Yuri.
Hey, boss.
If you're not too busy,
I'm trying to sell this place, and you're playing grab ass with Grandma. No, I wasn't.
Is that duct tape?
Yeah.
Look. We lost the lawyer in 206 and the single mom below him.
That wasn't my fault. They wanted to get a bigger place. Together.
And I can't sell the building because it looks like a halfway house.
I'm moving as fast as I can. And actually, I think we're doing pretty good.
When did we start letting cripples in the place?
Well, he's been here a couple of years. That's Caldo Vasco. It's the wheelchair that's recent.
Excuse me? Are you the owner of this building?
Yes, unless you're interested in buying, Mr. Vasco.
I was just wondering when I can expect to have a ramp at the front entrance.
A ramp?
Yeah.
Could you use the side door? See, we're dealing with a lot of damage from the earthquake, you know, plus there's the cost.
Well, I would be very happy to use the side door. It's just that my lawyer, ever since the accident, has gone a little crazy about the handicap rights. So, I don't have to explain it to you.
No, of course, of course. Yuri?
Yes?
Could you build this man a ramp?
Oh, excuse me. I didn't see you there. Yeah. Here we go.
You did that on purpose. I think I don't know you did that on purpose.
Hey, Harry. That thing in your left hand there, that's a hammer, you know.
Vasco, what's your glitch, man?
Glitch?
Yeah, you know, I'm kind of a big fan.
Oh, goody.
What the hell have I ever done to you?
Before I came to live here, you tried to charge me a $500 holding fee. And then 6.5 months later, I came back early from a holiday, and I found you and my lazy boy, along with the hooker.
But what have I done to you lately?
The other day, I came back from the hospital paralyzed from the waist down, and I discovered that somebody had polished off my last bottle of scotch.
How do you know it was me?
I found that on my bathroom floor. Hey, you want to give the lady a hand?
Calaguay.
Give it a rest. I'll take that. Go on, go on. Oh, that poor man.
Poor man, my ass. That guy, he gets away with murder.
Shame on you, Yuri. A drunk driver has put him in a wheelchair. Show some sympathy.
Caldo Vasco?
Yeah.
You've been served with the wrongful death of Cookie Thompson.
What, who?
Cookie, the purebred shih tzu you crushed with your car.
What is this, some kind of joke? That was an accident.
5 times over the legal limit, Mr. Vasco. Some people would call that manslaughter.
What are you doing?
I'm just enjoying a cool beverage. Would you like one?
Well, it's really gonna give me a lot of pleasure to get your ass fired.
What'd you have, like 2 periods with the Maple Leafs before they sent you back down? Maybe the pizza joint wouldn't have went under if somebody actually knew who the hell you were.
Well, you really are a piece of work.
You don't see me operating a motor vehicle while I'm wasted. Everybody has been bending over backwards to help you out. Meanwhile, I'm catching all the crap. How do you think they'd feel if they found out you put yourself in that chair?
What do you want?
I just want to do my job. I got a landlord breathing down my neck, a to-do list a mile long. I don't need another project. Just use the side door.
All right, fine. You keep your trap shut, and I'll live without the ramp. Deal?
I want that Dave Keon autographed hockey stick in your closet, too. Deal?
Deal.
I thought you were supposed to be building a ramp.
Oh, this was much higher on the list.
Really? What if there's a fire or something?
Hey, you've been on me for weeks to fix this. I'm fixing it. If you don't want me, just let me know and I'll go on to my other jobs.
I just think the poor man needs a ramp.
Oh, the poor man, he doesn't want a ramp anymore.
What?
You heard me.
Okay, what did you do?
Excuse me?
Bully him? Bribe him?
You really can't see past the chair to the jerk sitting in it, can you?
He is not a jerk.
Yeah, looking down your top?
He did no such thing.
Copping cheap feels?
He wouldn't do that.
And you guys act like nothing's going on, and I say one thing, and it's all Crouching Tiger hitting Grandma.
The poor man is a paraplegic.
The poor man did it to himself.
What?
Gotta do my job now.
No. What are you saying?
But only because you dragged it out of me.
Okay, yeah.
Hello. Well, here we are. Oh, excuse me. Would you mind?
It's probably best you get used to doing things by yourself, don't you think? Is that the dog killer?
Come on back here, you stool pigeon. Something you call life. I'm in it. Come on back here.
These boots are gonna walk all over you.
What the hell is this?
Boss!
Where's the ramp?
Vasco doesn't want it anymore.
Damn it, Yuri! I got a friend being in the TV crew here tomorrow. They're gonna shoot a piece about Vancouver being wheelchair-friendly. It'll help me sell this dump.
No. Tomorrow?
Finish the ramp. If you blow this, your ass is out of here.
Yuri?
Thanks.
We're all really impressed that you're still going to all this trouble for that. Anyway.
Yeah, well. Caring city, and Robson Arms is a caring, close-knit building. As soon as I heard that our tenant, Mr. Vasco, had his unfortunate accident, I knew that we had to become wheelchair-friendly, and it was long overdue. Robson Arms is conveniently located in a safe and desirable neighborhood close to numerous amenities, and it is an income generator.
You know what I'd love is a shot of the guy in the wheelchair using the ramp.
Of course. Excuse me. Find Vasco.
He's not gonna...
You bring him here right now, or start packing. So, now, Mr. Vasco, you know, he's shy, he's quiet, he's quite reserved, you know, like many of the people here in the building, Robson Arms.
Vasco! They want a shot of you using the ramp.
Tough titty.
Hey, I worked my ass off on that thing. That's the least you can do. Okay, all right. Look, I shouldn't have told people that stuff. I know, we had a deal, I broke my word. That was wrong. But if you could do this one thing for me, please. I'm gonna lose my job.
You know why the Leafs sent me back to the Farm League? Because I wasn't a team player.
Ah, mother! You're not going anywhere! I'm trying to reach the freaking
ramp! Get out of this go-kart! I'm telling you, kidnapped.
What it is?
Stop your whining, old man.
You'll go up the river for a long time. Let me alone.
Now listen to me. I built this ramp, and you're gonna go down this ramp.
I am not going down this ramp. This is what I'm gonna do.
Oh!
Hey. Oh.
Are you happy now?
Oh.
A story of neighborly love has turned into what some residents are calling a handicapped hate crime. The elderly paraplegic seemed to get things started when he grabbed the superintendent in the groin with a mechanical claw. The superintendent then dragged the man out of his wheelchair and down the ramp. Luckily, both brawlers escaped with only minor injuries. But when police arrived, former NHL player Caldo Vasco refused to press any charges. The owner of the building, Stuart Dubois, refused to comment. Aaron Hanuman, CTV News, West End.
Hi. You still having problems with the toilet?
Sure.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
What did you mean by that?
Dude, bringing down a cripple?
You coming back?
Probably have taken over the world now, a la Planet of the Apes.
Here's the scotch I borrowed.
Borrowed?
And I got your Dave Keon hockey stick right here.
Keep it. It's a fake. Keon hated my guts like I hated his. I wonder why I keep on collecting all this crap anyway. I think I'm gonna move. One of those places that they build for people like me.
Oh, yeah? Where's that, like Cootsville?
What?
I hear they got a lot of room in Dickering.
You know, there's one thing I'll say for you.
You haven't treated me any different since I came back.
It's my charm. Hi.
Hey, Uchao.
Well, everything's back to normal.
Yuri! Are you happy now? My super beats up a crippled tenant on TV. Do you know how many phone calls I've got? Do you know what a goddamn headache it is?
That wasn't my fault.
You're fired.
What for?
For gross incompetence, insubordination, for beating up a paraplegic. Take your pick.
You don't want to do that.
Mr. Vasco, I want to apologize.
Don't patronize me. You told Yuri to drag me out here. I assure you that if you fire him, your friends in the media will find out that you only had the ramp built when I threatened you with legal action.
Fine. Good. Keep him. And I wash my hands of this whole albatross. And you two ticks deserve each other.
Not much of a team player, huh?
No, but I wasn't bad in the fight. What the hell is this?
It's on the list.